Hello, this is going to be a lesson for lives by Modest Mouse. So I'm going to play along to the song and then teach it. Here we go. Okay, might do a lesson for that one next. So, it starts out on the second fret of the E string, and this is just in standard tuning. So it's first finger on the second fret of the E string on this F sharp, and then fourth fret of the A string, and you play. So it's E string once, and then open A. So, second fret of the E string, then open A, and then fourth fret of the A, like this. And then you're kind of doing like this 2-4-2 thing, like. So, second fret on the D string there, like this. And then open, fourth fret of the A string again. So. Open D string, A string again on the second fret, and then second fret of the G string, and kind of bend it there, so like this. Oops. And then fourth fret of the D. So that's the whole riff right there. Oops, fuck. you do it again. But once you get there, you do this all on the A string here. 2, 4, and then slide up to 7. So, sorry, 4, 2, 4, 7, 5, 5. So 2, 4, 7, 4, 2, open. Like this. And then open A. So the whole thing, that was really wordy. I'll post the tab. It'll make more sense with the tab. But it's like this, so. Just keeps playing that. So that's the whole riff, the thing. I'll play the, and I think it plays it like 3 or 4 times, I don't know. But after that, so, and you can also, if you want to, you can do 4th fret. I think the tab actually says that, but I like to do the open D there. But you can do it either way. It sounds good either way. So anyway, last time through. And then he does power chord. 2, 4, 4. 2, 2, 4, 4 on the A, D, and G. And the strumming pattern is just down, down, up. That down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. Down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. Down, down, up, down, up. And then it goes back into the main riff. It goes to the little interlude. And I kind of do that. It's 2nd fret of the E string. And you kind of just, you want to mute the A, but you can kind of let the rest of the strings ring besides the high E. So he does 2nd fret of the E, 3rd fret on this G, so, and then probably up to the 5th fret of the A string here, this D note, so. Then the entire interlude part is just on the fifth, it's on the A string and the G string, and it's 15-15. So it's 15th, and then you're muting the D, and then you have the open G string. And you're doing 15 down to 12. And this strumming pattern is kind of like, how to really say that, but so it's 15 12 15 12 10 8 3, and that's all just. Like that. And I usually actually play it with my middle and ring. And then once you get down to this, hold on 1 second, Margo. Where, how come you're out of bed? Okay, so 15 and 12. 15, 12, 10, 8, 3. And when you get down to the, to this 8-8 here, you can either do that, or you can do 7-8, like, either way sounds good. Hold on, Margo, kick it. I usually just do the 8-8, so you don't have to switch here, but sometimes I just try and move this finger down to the 7th fret, like that. Like that. And then you just strum this 3-3 chord. And this is the part where he's like, my mom's God is a woman, that part. It's all, you just hold this 3rd fret of the B string with your ring finger here, and you play. So you're just walking down the bass line here. So it's 3rd fret of the A string, 2nd fret, and then G, 3rd fret of the E. So. That was 2-3-2 on the E string, and then back. So like this. Back into the main riff. That's the whole song. All right, I gotta put my 3-year-old back in bed. Hopefully, I don't know. Hopefully that was helpful. And I'll do another one of these. And hopefully you guys are all doing well out there. Catch you on the next one.